If you are choosing a material for your next 3D printing project, you might be thinking about which is the strongest material out there. Depending on the requirements in your project, ultimate strength of your part might not be the most important thing you're looking for. Stiffness is also something that could be really important. In order to see how different materials compare in that regard, I built myself a testing apparatus and analyzed the most common 3D printing polymers for their rigidity. Guten Tag everybody, I'm Stefan and welcome to CNC Kitchen. Before you start complaining and tell me that we could have simply looked at the Young's modulus in a datasheet, let me tell you that datasheets often are a bit sugar-coated because they sometimes use test values not from 3D printed samples but from injection molded ones. Then there is the point that 3D printed parts have print direction dependent properties, especially if we take a look at fiber reinforced ones. And at last, just taking a look at a datasheet doesn't make a good video. So for this video, I've been taking a look at the most common 3D printing materials, which cover PLA, ABS, PETG, nylon and polypropylene, but also include special ones like annealed PLA, carbon fiber reinforced PETG and something pretty cool that is nano diamond reinforced PLA from Tiamat3D, where I was sent a role to play with. So the stiffness of a material is characterized by the Young's modulus, which is the initial slope in a stress strain diagram and often measured in a tensile testing machine. The Young's modulus or tensile modulus is the proportionality factor between the load on a material and the resulting deformation or strain. A material with a higher Young's modulus is stiffer or more rigid, so a higher amount of force is needed to deform a sample. For comparison, the usual moduli of plastics that we commonly print are between 1000 and 3000 megapascals. Aluminum is already by an order of magnitude stiffer with around 70,000 megapascals, titanium is at 110,000 MPa and steel has a Young's modulus of over 200,000 megapascals. I'm usually analyzing that property for my filament tests, but with the test setup I built myself, it's quite hard to measure the tiny displacements happening. Another method is to use a bending or a flexural test. For a 3-point bending test, you load the sample that sits on two supports in the center and measure the displacement for a given amount of load and then calculate the bending modulus with these values and the dimensions of your specimens. There are standards for that like the ISO 178 and I did my best to recreate that setup as good as possible, but in the end the dimensions and the setup that I used doesn't fully comply with these standards, so be aware how you use my results. I designed a jig in Fusion 360 where I added slots for dowel pins. These pins are exactly spaced 100 mm from each other and will act as bearings. The sample itself will be loaded with this hook-shaped part, where also a dowel pin will transmit the force to the sample. The lower hole will be used to connect a bucket, where I'll add weights step by step. The sample itself is a simple bar that is 120 mm long, 12 mm wide and 4 mm high. All of the samples were printed on my CR10 with a Titan Aero extruder and a 0.4 mm nozzle at 0.2 mm layer height, 5 perimeters and 100% infill. All of the CAD files are by the way available on Thingiverse if you want to build one your own. If we take a look again at the formula that will be used to calculate the bending modulus, we'll see that especially the thickness is very important because it goes into the equation by a power of 3, so a small deviation from the nominal value will set off the results a lot. For this reason, I documented all of the dimensions of the samples and also weighed them before the tests. This is especially interesting for the annealed PLA specimens. Not only do we see that it is less translucent than the unannealed one, but it also changed its shape quite a bit during the crystallization that happened during the annealing process. It got shorter, but also quite a bit thicker, which definitely needs to be taken into consideration for the test evaluation. The test setup is pretty simple. I placed the jig on my vise and leveled it. The specimen is placed on the dowel pins and the U-shaped hook will load it in the middle. I placed the dial gauge above the hook that will measure the deflection of the sample. I attached a bucket in which I'll successively place soda cans that each weigh 353 grams, so we'll load the samples with 3.46 newtons. So I always added a can, noted the deflection, and then added another one up to 4, which worked very nicely. The only problem was the polypropylene sample that was so compliant that measurements were hard to make and I had to stop after the addition of 2 cans. The results were very nice because you can see the linear relation between load and deflection. The more shallow the curve, the more rigid a material is. If we calculate the bending modulus, which also incorporates the dimension of the samples, we get the following results. As expected, PP is by far the least stiff material with a modulus of only around 300 MPa. My nylon was at around 1000 MPa. ABS and PETG are at roughly 2000 MPa and PLA is even an additional 50% stiffer with 3000 MPa in the as printed state and even a bit stiffer if you anneal the material. The carbon fiber reinforced PETG doubles the stiffness of normal PETG and the new boy on the block, nano diamond reinforced PLA, is the most rigid with almost 5000 MPa bending modulus. I told you in the beginning that I also weight the samples to calculate the density. If you want to have a lightweight structure that is stiff, you might be interested which material gives you the maximum amount of stiffness with the least weight. The orange bars in this plot show the weighted stiffnesses by density, where some small things change because nylon, due to its lower stiffness, gets a little better and PETG loses in comparison to ABS due to its higher density. The rest stays pretty much the same and the reinforced materials still win. But keep in mind that especially for the reinforced materials, the stiffness can be highly dependent on the printing orientation, so you need to put some thoughts into their application, otherwise they are not better than their unreinforced counterparts. So I think I was able to give you a nice overview about another important mechanical property of 3D printed materials. So, if you have an application where stiffness and not strength is important, choose a suitable material. But also keep in mind that the stiffness of a section under bending increases by the power of 3 with its thickness, so just adding a bit more thickness to your part might even have a much higher impact. Let me know down in the comments what you think of my tests and the results I've got. Alright guys, thanks for watching and if you have learned something, please hit the like button and consider supporting my work on Patreon. Subscribe if you aren't yet and select the bell to get notified when new videos are released. I hope to see you in the next one. Auf Wiedersehen and until next time.